Hello everyone, myself Sneha Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Today I will explain you about two-dimensional continuous random variable and its distribution functions from the subject of probability and statistics. In the last session, I had explained you about two-dimensional discrete random variable. As you know that two-dimensional means we will take coordinates in terms of x and y. And if we will taking discrete random variable, then the meaning of discrete means countably infinite number or the finite number. Now we have to take infinite number of variables. So for that we will take continuous random variable. So for this, if we want to take infinite number of random variables, so we can't add all this term infinitely, right? So for this we will take integration of it. So all the equations will be same like discrete random variable, only the difference is that instead of summation we will take integration. Now the first topic is joint probability distribution function. Joint probability distribution is a combined combination of x and y, so it will representing as if x and y is a two-dimensional random variable such that probability of x minus dx by 2, x is in between x minus dx by 2 to x plus dx by 2, and y is in between y minus dy by 2 to y plus dy by 2 is equals to f of xy dy. Now meaning of this is this small variable, small distance or small variable as dx, small change of dx and small change in y means dy. So if we are taking this, then f of x comma y is called the joint probability distribution function of x and y. So if it satisfies the following condition, then and then only it will consider as it is a joint probability distribution function. Now the first property or first condition is that f of x comma y should be greater than or equals to 0 for every x and y. Now what is the meaning of this? Meaning is that f of x comma y, it means it is basically considered as probability of x and y, right? So the probability of x and y should be always greater than or equals to 0. The probability value can't be negative. So we will take this as a first condition as f of x comma y should be greater than or equals to 0 for every x and y. Now the second property is integration minus infinite to infinite, integration minus infinite to infinite f of x comma y dx dy equals to 1. It means this is a joint probability distribution function, means we will combinedly taking the probability of x and y. So for that, for x we will take this integration and for y we will take this integration, means for x and y we will take two integration and the total of this should be equals to 1. It means sure event, right? So for the sure event we will take it as a 100%, means the value of this equals to 1. Now in this, not that if we will taking probability of x which is greater than or equal in between a and b and probability of y in between c and d, then we will integrate over this. X will be in between a to b and y will be in between c to d. So we will integrate for this portion only, and if we will finding f of x comma y dx dy, then it will gives you the probability of x in between a to b and y in between c to d. Now the next topic is cumulative distribution function. Cumulative means joint distribution function of whole term. So f xy of x comma y is equals to minus infinite to y integration, my integration minus infinite to x f of x comma y dx dy. Marginal probability function can be written as fx of x equals to integration minus infinite to infinite f of x comma y dy. Similarly, if we will finding marginal probability function for y, then fy of y equals to integration minus infinite to infinite f of x comma y dy dx. So if we'll taking marginal probability function for x, then we have to integrate with respect to y. And if you want to find out marginal probability function for y, then we have to integrate with respect to x. Now the next point is conditional probability function. Now what is conditional probability function? If the input x is given to you and you have to find out probability of y, or if y is given to you and you have to find out probability of x, then for that we will use conditional probability. So f of x given y equals to joint probability function f of x comma y given that fy of y. Similarly, f of y given x equals to joint probability means f of x comma y given that fx of x. So divide by fx of x. A necessary condition for the continuous random variable x and y to be independent is f of x comma y, this should be equals to fx of x into fy of y. It means these two are independent to each other. Now this all the functions can be well defined by using some example. The first example is the joint probability density function of a two-dimensional random variable is f of x comma y equals to 1 by 2 x e raised to minus y. This value is for x in between 0 to 2 and y is greater than 0, and 0 for otherwise. Find the cumulative distribution function. So to find cumulative distribution function, you can see from this equation that if you want to find out cumulative distribution function, then we will integrate 2 times, first for y and second for x. So minus infinite to y, minus infinite to x. And we will take joint function of fxy and we will integrate with respect to x and y. So f of x comma y is given to you. If you will take integration of this two with respect to x and y, then you can find out cumulative distribution function. Now to find out this, we will starting from f of x comma y is equals to integration minus infinite to y, integration minus infinite to x, f of x comma y dx dy. This is the original equation. Now we will put the value of f of x comma y from this. Right, so if we'll put in the value, then this term will becomes like 1 by 2 x e raised to minus y. Instead of f of x comma y, we will put this, then dx, then dy. Now, what will be the range of this integration? This range will convert into x will be convert in between 0 to 2, right? So minus infinite to 0, this term will becomes 0. So this term will becomes from 0 to x. Similarly, y is greater than 0. So this will convert as a 0 to y. You can see that if we will taking minus infinite to x, in this we will divide this whole range into two parts. The first part as minus infinite to 0 and the second part as 0 to x. Now for 0 to 2, if we'll taking 2 over here or 2 over here, so for 0 to 2, its value equals to this, right? And for this value, its value equals to 0. So we will remove this term. So the integration range will become 0 to x. Similarly, the range of y will become 0 to y. Now simply we have to integrate this two term 1 by 1. So if we will integrating this term, then the next term will becomes like this 1. Now the next step is we will integrating this as with respect to x. 1 by 2 is common, so it will outside of this integration 0 to y. Integration with respect to x will give you, for x it will becomes x square by 2. This e raised to minus y is constant, so it will be outside of this integration. Dx will be goes because of this integration, and over here this term will becomes dy. Now if we will putting higher range over here, so it will becomes x square minus lower range means 0. So x square minus 0 by 2, it means x square by 2. So x square by 2, now this term is with respect to integration with respect to y. So x square by 2 is common part, so it will be outside of this integration. So So the next step will becomes x square by 2 into 2 means 4 integration 0 to y e raised to minus y dy. Now if we will integrating this part, then it will gives you the term as minus e raised to minus y, and we will put the range as 0 to y. Now if we will simplifying this, then the term will becomes like this, x square by 4, this term will becomes e raised to minus y minus 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 plus e raised to 0. So if we will simplifying this term, then it will gives you the term as 1 into this. So x square by 4, 1 minus e raised to minus y. E raised to 0 means 1 minus e raised to minus y will be as it is. So if we will writing the last step as final function as f of x comma y, its answer is x square by 4, 1 minus e raised to minus y. This one is for this case, right? For x in between 0 to 2 and y is greater than 0. For x in between 0 to 2 and for y is greater than 0. Otherwise, its value is 0. So this is your final answer. Now the next example is the joint probability density function of a two-dimensional random variable x comma y is fx y equals to x e raised to minus x of y plus 1 for x greater than 0, y greater than 0. Examine whether the variable x and y are independent. So in this example, you have to check whether these two terms are independent or not. So for this, first of all, we will find out the marginal probability of x, which is fx of x equals to integration minus infinite to infinite f of x comma y dy. Now if we will put in this value in this equation, then the term will becomes x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0, right? So greater than 0 means the range will become 0 to infinite. Instead of f of x comma y, we will put this value. So x e raised to minus x y plus 1 dy. Now if we will integrating this, then x is common part, so it will outside of this integration, and the integration of this term will becomes like e raised to minus x of y plus 1 divided by, this term is constant, so e raised to y, its answer is 1, and because of this minus x, its integration is divided by minus x, and the range will become 0 to infinite. Now if we will simplifying this term, then x, the first term will becomes e raised to minus infinite, because instead of this we will put infinite. Infinite plus 1 means infinite into x means infinite. So the overall answer is e raised to minus infinite minus e raised to 0 upon minus x. X will be cancel out. E raised to minus infinite means 0. E raised to minus 0 means minus 1 upon minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 cancel out. So its answer equals to 1. Now the next term we have to find out is fy of y equals to integration minus infinite to infinite f of x comma y dx, right? So if we will put in the value of f of x comma y, then x e raised to minus x y plus 1 dx. This one is for range for x greater than 0 and y greater than 0. So because of this, this integration will convert into this 0 to infinite x e raised to minus x y plus 1 dx. Now if we will integrating this, then the part will becomes like this. X will be as it is e raised to minus x y plus 1, and this integration is minus y plus 1. Because x with respect to x, so this term is considered as constant, so it will be divided by this term. Similarly, if we are taking e raised to minus x into y plus 1 as common part, then integration differentiation of x equals to 1 divided by this part square means y plus 1 whole square. Over here we have used integration u into dv. So using this, we can solve this term. then the answer of this equals to 1 upon y plus 1 whole square. So this one is for y greater than 0. Now from these two equations, this one is answer 1 and this one is answer 2. From these two, you can see that these two are independent to each other. Why? Because fx, y, this does not equals to fx of x into fy of y. When we will multiplying this two term, it will not giving the f of x, y. So this way we can say that x and y both are independent to each other. So x and y are not independent.